Welcome to Hops in Focus, where we take a deep dive into the hops that make craft beer unique. Today, we'll be talking about one of the OG American big boys.
John Candy.
Simcoe. So, Chris.
Simcoe.
What do we know about it?
Simcoe. American hop, grown in the year 2000. Guess where?
Oh, America.
Yeah, I've just told you that. Guess what state?
Was it Washington?
Yeah, I mean, perhaps no surprise that it was Washington, home of the Yakima Valley, but guess who grew it?
Was it Yakima Chief Ranches, by any chance?
Yeah, I mean, it was Yakima Chief Ranches. Mm. Grown and released in the year 2000 under the name YCR14.
Sexy.
And it was named Simcoe after Simcoe County in southern Ontario in Canada in honour of French-Canadian hop growers.
Because apparently there's quite a lot in Yakima Valley.
I don't know, I've never been there.
No, apparently there is. Well, I do my research.
Let's do a census.
No.
No, but if we were going to do a census, one of the questions that I would have on there is, who invented Simcoe specifically?
I can tell you, Chris.
Go on then.
So it was a guy called Charles Zimmerman.
Ah, Chuck Zimmerman to his friends.
Chuck to his friends. So he's actually the credited published patent inventor of Simcoe.
Okay.
But I think Simcoe really came into its own when a guy called Jason Perot was one of the hop breeders at Yakima Chief Ranches, and he took on the Simcoe variety and then bred it to become what's known and loved today.
Ah, so Jason Perot is the current CEO of Yakima Chief Ranch.
Oh, okay.
And he's also the head hop breeder there, so he's still around.
Climbing up the corporate ladder.
So with that, Paul, what are our barometers of the Simcoe hop in this episode?
So we've got, yet again, a beer from Verdon.
Oh God, not again.
Not again.
Not another one.
But you know, they keep knocking out these brilliant beers, so we've got to keep drinking them.
And this did really fit the style, didn't it?
We were after
just a straightforward, straight hop Simcoe. There it is.
And there we go. So this is version 3 of their Big Stupid Westie, West Coast IPA, 6.8%, single hop Simcoe. Cannot wait.
And on this one, we have Two Flints. I believe this is their first appearance on the channel.
Ah, their maiden.
They've made an appearance, more like. But this brewery, Two Flints, they are from Windsor. There's a nice little scene kind of building up in Windsor.
Yeah, and they're exploding up, man. They're doing really well here in the UK.
Very well hyped, and 2023 was a big year for them. So it'd be nice to actually try some of their beers. And this is a Columbus and Simcoe hopped one, 4.8%, and it's a bright pale.
Lovely.
We've had a bright IPA on the channel before in the last Hops and Focus video, which was Citra. So if you haven't watched that, give it a cheeky little watch and you'll be able to find out what a bright IPA is, because quite frankly, I don't remember anymore. No. So which one of these should we go with first?
Well, let's crack them both.
I'll pour these.
Yeah, you do that one, I'll do this one. All good.
So Paul, what are we expecting from Simcoe here?
So, what we're expecting, well, first and foremost, it's a dual purpose hop, so it's going to be used for flavour and aroma, essentially, and you can use it for both. It's particularly good for bittering, so it's got really high alpha acids.
I say, you see it pop up a lot in the West Coast styles, don't you?
Yeah, so I mean, hence the beer. So I'm expecting this to be even better than last year, if Simcoe lives up to its bitter nature. So yeah, 12 to 14% alpha acids, so yeah, it's pretty pokey. But you know, I mean, aroma wise, I'm thinking we're going to get some classic West Coast.
I think we're going to get pine, we're going to get citrus. I mean, those are usually, you could have a bingo card, couldn't you, for these sort of things, and you're going to get...
So fruit.
Which one are we going to go for first?
Let's start with the slightly lower ABV. So let's go with the Two Flints, I think.
Yep.
It's always good to do that. So,
I mean,
do you have a smell?
Clarity-wise,
oh yeah, look at
it's,
that.
It's looking kind of like what a modern West Coast would look like.
100%. Because
not a traditional West Coast, which is crystal lager clear, but this is very much a bit more.
I mean, that could pass for an unfiltered lager quite happily, though.
Yeah. So on the ronk. Oh, okay. Not much in the way of fruit there.
No, it's undeniably West Coast style, but I'm. Yeah, it's not.
Yeah,
it's not punching me with any particular flavours.
I tell you what, I'm getting
the pine's
I'm getting quite a bit of savour actually. I'm getting.
Yeah, you are actually. Yeah. Is
it onioniness?
So onion and garlic is a bit of a tasting note on these, or a smelling note in this case. But yeah,
that's interesting, and it makes a nice change actually, because the amount of times we've done these Hops in Focus videos now, we're almost always putting, when we go to Hopland, we're almost always putting the same same words around us. It's all like stone fruit, tropical. But it's actually interesting now that I reckon I can whack up
onions.
Onions and garlic, because there's definitely something about that. It's quite savoury. Cheers.
God gave rock and roll to you.
Glorious. Yeah.
Get in. I think the woody nature of Simcoe is quite prevalent there, the piney woodiness, but yeah, woody in particular. Not getting much in the way of like classic grapefruit.
I'm getting something quite, I mean, I'm getting, I suppose, the pithiness of citrus. There's quite a bit of that.
Yeah, there's a lot of bitterness actually, but
orange skin.
There's a lot of bitterness there, but it's not particularly packed full of flavour, I don't think.
It's quite easy sipping.
And it's very easy drinking though,
It's easy sipping and it's quite nicely bitter. It's got a nice balance between...
Getting a little bit of that classic kind of peachiness going on.
To be fair, there is...
It lingers a little bit, yeah.
You said peach, why not? Yeah.
Tick, stone fruit. Nailed it.
So obviously, bright beers, bright IPA, bright pale. I seem to recall that when we looked it up, it's a spin-off of the West Coast style, but it kind of stems from more the northwestern element of the... Well, so obviously where Simcoe is from. And I think bright IPAs and bright pales have a more pronounced malt bill.
I think that's what it... I think that's where we get that, the more earthy vibe on that one a little bit. And there's a little bit of that kind of very subtle caramelisation, I think, on the back of that. But it's pleasant beer. Quite happy to see everyone drink that.
Yeah. With that said, let's see how Verdant have dialed Simcoe up to 11 and put it into their big, stupid West Coast IPA.
Okay. Well, as I said, I loved this last year, so it smells good.
Again, the one thing that you're always going to get, is probably really with Verdant beers, is just that kind of... There is that verdanty smell, isn't there? There's that undeniable bit of melon, just which...
And also vegetative...
Yes, yeah.
Because you said onion and garlic in that last one.
Onion juice.
I'm getting a lot of that.
Yeah.
But that feels quite verdanty anyway, you know?
Well, that is, yeah.
But I think that's more their yeast doing its thing, but combined with that hop, then, yeah.
Fantastic.
It's big. I'm just going to go in.
So 6.8%, we should be expecting something... bit punchy.
It's quite subtle.
It is actually.
What for a West Coast and a 6.8% beer? Again, very smooth.
Bloody hell. Yeah. Actually, it doesn't leave a lot of lasting bitterness.
No.
Bitter up front. But then it kind of just dissipates slightly. Like, it's like one of those graphs that goes whoop.
The graph.
Yeah.
Don't get much in the way of other taster notes with Simcoe. So I think what we're looking for is, you know, we've mentioned earthiness and we've mentioned fruitiness and we've mentioned the classic citrus, peach, apricot, but there's typically hints and notes of berry in Simcoe.
So,
but I'm not really getting any of that, to be honest.
I've just had Night Air, the Two Flints beer.
Yep.
After that, and the malt there now is undeniable. Like, you know, we're talking about that traditional English style of beer that's just quite malty.
Yeah. Oh, we had that with the red IPA thing, didn't we, as well? Yeah. So, yeah, that's... yeah, you're right. In comparison, actually, and here's a weird thing now, the mouthfeel on that is getting amped up massively.
Mm.
And I'm also getting a bit of mint going on.
You know what? That is actually a very good show.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's kind of a bit toothpastey.
It's you know, when you breathe in and it kind of leaves that coldness that mint would.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, I mean, two absolutely stellar examples of the Simcoe hop. I feel like I've learned something and I hope you have too.
Yeah, one thing
before
we go though. Did you know that Simcoe is also known as Cascade on steroids? So that's given me a little idea for what we can do on our next Hopped in Focus video.
Steroids?
No. 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 Obviously not.
Which one then?
Right, just sip it. Just
what are the
learn your lines.
What hop are you talking about?
Just learn your lines. I'm going to bed.